this lady to be with?
Maybe not.
All right, everybody be seated. So we're gathered here in the presence of God. Today they will receive God's greatest gift, another person to share, to grow with, to change with, to be joyful with, and to stand with. As when trials and tribulations enter their lives, it is fitting, therefore, that we should on this occasion begin by asking God's blessing upon this marriage. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, in Jesus' name we come before you this afternoon. And God, we thank you, Lord, for Randall and Rebecca, Lord, and I know, God, they're thankful, Lord, that their paths have crossed. And Lord, as they come together tonight, Lord, they're coming home. Lord, we ask you, God, that you would bless them, God, from this day and forever, Lord, and just keep your hands upon them, their home, their marriage. Protect them, God. Help them to be strong when they feel weak. God, give them grace to stand when they feel like running, Lord. And bless them all the days of their life, we pray. And may they fear you. May they live for you, God. May they serve you. In Jesus' name, amen. In the book of Ephesians, the Bible says, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify it and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be as one flesh. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husband as unto the Lord. Randall, will you have this woman as your lawfully wedded wife to live together after God's ordinances, holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her? Will you comfort her? Will you honor her? Keep her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only to her so long as you both shall live. Rebecca, you have this man as your lawfully wedded husband to live together after God's ordinances, holy estate of matrimony. Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, keep him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, forsaking all others, keeping yourselves only to him so long as you both shall live? Need the ring, young man. These rings are a symbol of love. And they forever remind us of your pledge to one another. May your compassion and kindness for one another always be like these rings, with no beginning and no ending. Randall, please place this ring up on Rebecca's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, with all that I am, with all that I have. I honor you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I bet you can place this ring upon his hand. Right. Repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, with all that I am and all that I have. I honor you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Based on the charge that you have received today and based on the vows that you have taken in the sight of God and witnesses today, Randall and Rebecca, we rejoice with you that two roads brought you here, and you will now leave as one. Now, by the authority invested in me as the minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, of the Lord, in the presence of God and the assembled of these witnesses, I pronounce you husband and wife You have given sacred vows before each other, before us, and before a holy and righteous God. These vows are never to be broken. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You will now kiss your bride. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're now presenting unto you Mr. and Mrs. Randall Swell. Give them a better hand clap than that.
Jeremiah.